Human, in honor of Darren and that EP. was such a good show. I know that I had mentioned that I thought Apocalyptor was like the best moment that I have, excuse me, ever experienced in my life, but at that moment I thought, nope, this for sure surpasses Apocalyptor. Listen Up Door is where it's at. I've never been happier than that time. It was such a good show. I didn't get to meet him, but I did have so much fun. It was so cool to hear him perform these new songs that he had, and to hear him perform Glee songs and Disney songs, and then a little bit of his old stuff too. Let's talk about his music. He came out with this EP called Homework, and in this one it has Foolish Thing, I Dreamed a Dream, Going Nowhere, I Don't Mind, and The Day the Dance is Over. So here it is, and yes, it is signed by Mr. Darren Criss himself. He did like a little special bundle when this came out.
Saying
so cool if I was able to see him in New York. But anyways, I thought that that was over. I was never going to see Darren perform as Hedwig. That was my one chance. I had missed that chance. And then he goes and surprises us that he was gonna start doing San Francisco shows and LA shows for the Hedwig tour. And I thought, okay, this is my opportunity. I'm gonna be able to go and see him and potentially meet him, because he always goes at stage door after the show and meets all his fans. So I was ready for this. I bought floor tickets. I think they were fourth row. And I invited my sister and we went, and it was so much fun. I had the best time. He rocked that show. It was something that I thought I was never gonna have the opportunity to do, and I'm so happy that he was able to come to LA and I was able to see that show. It was at the Pantages Theater, and oh my god, that theater was so beautiful. So we're waiting there, right? We're waiting for the show to start, and we were like so excited because the show was gonna start, and then we were gonna go after and get to meet him. And then Darren tweets that he was not gonna go out that specific night because it was the night of the Trump versus Hillary Clinton election. So me and my sister Sarita were like, okay, you know what, that's fine, we're not gonna get to meet him, but we're here, we're fourth row, let's enjoy it. And it was just a magical show. At the end of the show, Hedwig sings a song, and I was literally in tears. It was just that moment that I shared with Darren, or that we shared with everyone in the room. It was just so beautiful. I'll never forget the way that it made me feel. I was just in awe of the person in front of me, and I was so excited that I was able to finally experience him playing Hedwig. After that, we went home, and you know, we were pretty sad because we didn't get to meet him. And then we were even sadder because Trump had won the election. So we went home, and you know, we were thinking about it. We're like, you know what, he's in LA, he's doing more shows, we can probably come back, not buy such expensive tickets, and maybe get a chance to meet him. So my sister was like, yeah, I'm down. So I went and bought tickets, I think maybe 2 weeks after, and they were balcony tickets, so we were very far, very high up, but it was still such a great and amazing show. I didn't cry this time, but I just loved it. And every show is different because Hedwig interacts with the audience, and you know, everyone has different reactions and acts a different way, so it was like a brand new show. It was so good. And then afterwards, we literally ran to stage door and were, I believe, like the second or third people in line, and we finally got our chance to meet the wonderful Darren Criss. And I know a lot of people always say, like, don't meet your heroes, because you would just look at them in a different light. And not with Darren. He was so sweet, so kind. He literally gave you all his attention when it was your turn. And yeah, I was just in awe of him. I think he asked me for my name, and I told him my name, and I wasn't speaking. Like, there was nothing that I can tell this person who has, like, saved me in so many different ways. And I completely, like, went, I just shut down. I couldn't find the words to tell him. And he finally was like, okay, well, if you're not gonna talk to me, I'm gonna talk to your sister. And my sister had, like, a full-on conversation. I was so proud of her. I mean, I was happy regardless. Darren was right there, but I was so proud of her because she's usually very shy, and she got to tell him how much he meant to her, and it was so just missed him. Darren walked right in front of me. And at first I thought he was lying, but no, sure enough, we see like all these people around and they like moved Darren into a little private party area where no one was able to go unless you had a ticket. And we were so upset. We were just like, oh my God, that was our chance. But it was still a lovely night. It was so much fun. And it's, if you're a Darren Criss fan, you know how much we have always wanted him to play Prince Eric. And that was really cool to finally see it come to life. It was really awesome. The last thing that I'm going to be talking about is Darren's new music. This is Darren's new single. Well, his first single to his new music. And this is called Zoom call live stream that he was gonna do with everyone that purchased the album and the ticket. So I bought this the first day that he announced it. I was like on it. I was like, I'm gonna get it. I want that ticket and I'm gonna get it. And then they say, oh, there's gonna be a contest. If you bought the album, there was a chance that you could win like this special ticket. Gonna be Smith.